Can you feel a difference in the air here today? Yeah. There is a significant difference. There really is. And it's absolutely awesome. It's amazing what God will do if we're in sync with Him. Shavuot starts tonight at sundown. And I spoke last week about how important Shavuot is, that it's the anniversary of the giving the law on Mount Sinai, and it's the anniversary of giving the Spirit in the upper room. Acts chapter 1, verse 8 says, "You shall receive power after the Ruach HaKodesh has come, and you will be witnesses unto me in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth." So let's break that down. We're going to receive power, not only power, but we're going to receive authority. And what is the purpose of that power and that authority? To be witnesses. Do you think He would give us that power and that authority so that we can say, "Thank you, Lord," and sit on our, you know what? The purpose for giving us power and authority is for us to go out and bring people in to share the Besura, the good news. That's the purpose of giving us power and authority. Luke 24:49 says, "Now I am sending forth upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been equipped with power from above." This is not earthly power. This is supernatural power that comes from the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And the number one need in the body today is the power of the Ruach HaKodesh, because without it, we're powerless. The number one prerequisite for having that power is to hunger after it. We have to desire it. We have to want it. Matthew 5:6 says, "Blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled." Not may be filled. Shall be filled. It's automatic. The most dangerous thing that can happen to a believer is to lose their hunger and their passion and their desire for the presence and the power of God. Amen. Amen is right. Let me tell you, you all need to start responding. See, this is not a soliloquy. This is group participation. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Can I hear a louder amen?
Amen.
Amen. We need to get excited about the Word of God. Let me tell you about the Word of God. I said to Jackie yesterday, I said, "Jackie, I want to go to this service, healing service tonight." And she said, "Why do you want to go?" I said, "Well, I know of the guy that's going to be there, Bob Weiner, and he's got a really great reputation, and we both need a touch, so let's go." So we got there. It was called for 7:30 in Cooper City. It was part of the South Florida Pastors Network who sponsored it. And we're looking around, and it's a miracle and healing service, and there's nobody there. And I looked at Jackie, and she looked at me, and I said, "I don't understand this. I know there are hurting people all over South Florida. Why aren't there lines around the building? Why is it?" And ultimately, it only got half full, if that. And it wasn't that big a facility. Listen, you have to hunger after your healing. You have to hunger after your deliverance. You can't sit there and wait for God to drop it in your lap. You need to be proactive.
Amen.
So he did a message that I recorded that was, I thought, he was right on the money. And he goes on college campuses all over the country and plants churches. He went into the University of Florida, which is a hotbed of communism, and they now have prayer meetings right on campus that have thousands of people attending them every Sunday night. He's planted thousands of churches all over the world, and he does it based on a simple principle. Go get them, disciple them, tell them the whole truth and nothing but the truth. Do not sugarcoat it. Do not give them these phony, joy-filled messages that life is going to be a bed of roses. Disciple them. Tell them the truth. Turn them loose and let them multiply. And toward the end of the service, he said, I want to pray for everyone who needs a healing. Well, I guess about 20 people went up. And he keeps looking at me. And we're right there by the stage, and he keeps looking at me. He doesn't say anything, but he keeps looking at me. And we're making, I mean, we're 4 feet apart, and he keeps making eye contact with me. And he says, okay, now anybody who feels that they were healed, I want you to come up here. Come up here. So several people come up, and they give a brief testimony, and and I said to Jackie, I said, I can move my right arm. I said, I don't know what happened, but for the last 3 years, I haven't been able to do this. She says, well, get up there. So I went up there, and he said, I was wondering how long it was going to take you to get up here, because I know the Lord healed you. He told me. Well, they told me I needed a shoulder replacement, but I could not do that. I haven't been able to sleep on this shoulder in 3 years. I slept on that shoulder last night. So, you know, I'm not telling you this because I'm special. I'm telling you this because God wants to heal you. He wants to deliver you from whatever is coming against you. But you know what? You got to trust that he can do it. Because if you don't trust that he can do it, guess what? That will be your reality. But if you believe with every fiber of your being that he is who he says he is, that he will do exactly what he says he will do, then by golly, you will be healed. You will be set free. That's how simple it is. So the most dangerous thing that can happen to a believer is to lose their hunger and their passion and their desire for the presence and the power of God. Let me hear an amen. Amen. That's better. Wow. You know, when you respond like that, it empowers me. It does. It sets me more on fire. I'm already on fire. I really feel it. I feel the presence of the Lord. I felt it all morning in here. There is a different atmosphere in here. There is an atmosphere of joy in here. Hallelujah. Come with me to Ezekiel chapter 47. Ezekiel 47 shows us a picture of the mighty river of God. And that river represents the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, the anointing, if you will. Then he brought me back to the entrance of the house, and I saw water flowing eastward from under the threshold of the house, for the house faced eastward. And the water flowed down from under the right side of the house, south of the altar. Next, he led me out through the north gate and took me around the outside to the outer gate by way of the east gate, where I saw water trickling from the south side. And with a line in his hand, the man went out toward the east and measured 1,000 cubits. That's approximately 1/3 of a mile. And he had me wade across the stream. And the water came up to my ankles. And he measured 1,000 and had me wade the water. This time the water reached my knees. And he measured 1,000. He made me wade up to my waist. And he measured another 1,000, and it was a river, and I couldn't cross it on foot because the water was so deep. One would have to swim across. It was a river that could not be waded through. And he asked me, human being, have you seen this? Then guiding me, he got me back to the riverbank. And after being returned, I saw on the bank of the river a great number of trees. On the one side and on the other side. And he said to me, this water flows toward the eastern region and continues down to the Arava. When it enters the sea of stagnant water, the Dead Sea, its waters will become fresh. Well, I don't know if you've ever been to the Dead Sea, but the salt content in the Dead Sea is so high that you cannot swim in that water. It is impossible. All you can do is lay back and float. And that water is so buoyant that you can read a newspaper while you're floating in the Dead Sea. And for that water to be turned fresh, only the God of Israel could accomplish that miracle. Hallelujah. And when this happens, swarms, of all kinds of living creatures will be able to live in it wherever the streams flow, so that there will be a vast number of fish. For this water is flowing there so that wherever the river goes, everything will be restored and will be able to live. Can you picture this? God is a God of restoration. He can take a wilderness. He can take something that's dead and bring it back to life. Amen? Hallelujah. Psalm 46:4 says, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God. I want to tell you, we've come to the door of that river. We're right there. And this doesn't mean just come to Yeshua as a point of access, but it means come to Yeshua and fellowship with him and commune with him and have a relationship with him and talk to him, panim el panim, face to face. He is the living God. He is the Word that became flesh and dwelt among us. He is the one that allows us to tabernacle with he and the Father for all eternity, because he paid the price that was due each and every one of us. Amen would be appropriate, maybe even hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. John 7:37. If any man thirst, let him come to me and drink, and he that believes upon me, as the scriptures have said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. Thus he spoke of the Spirit. For the Ruach HaKodesh had not yet been given because Yeshua was not yet glorified. But what he was prophesying to them was, stick around. You ain't seen nothing yet. I'm going to fill you with power from above. Dunamis power, dynamite power, power like you've never seen before. Power that will enable you to raise the dead, to heal the sick, to cast out demons, to do all kinds of things in my name and under my authority.
Amen. Amen.
Yeshua said, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall bring forth much fruit. How do you know believers? By their fruit. No fruit? You got to ask yourself a really important question. What does Yaakov say? What does he say? No fruit, no salvation. Wow. We all have to bear fruit. I like pineapples. Of course, we have a lemon tree, and it's bearing fruit, and I like those lemons, too. So maybe we combine the two. It'll be a lemon pineapple. But we do, really, all seriousness aside, we have to bear fruit for the kingdom. He also said, if you abide not in me, you will be cast forth like a dead branch and cast into the fire. What does it mean to abide in him? Does that mean that you say a prayer and recognize him as Lord and Master of your life and then go about your business? No, abiding in him is making him Lord and Master. That means you go to him with every issue, little or big, and consult with him. Because you want to be in the will of God, not out of the will of God. And how do you know what the will of God is? You ask. You have his word to tell you the basics. But if you're undecided, if you still don't understand, you just go before the throne and you say, "Explain it to me." And guess what? That's exactly what he will do. His word says, if you lack wisdom, to ask, and he will pour it out, how? Liberally. Amen? Hallelujah. Wow. So the secret to abundant life, overflowing life, and anointed life is a life lived in fellowship with Messiah Yeshua. You can't have the abundant life without the relationship. And that relationship means that he comes first. Not your spouse, not your kids, not your job, not anything. That he has to come first. And that you have to choose to put him first. Amen? Our goal is not to have the power of God, but to have the presence of God. Hallelujah. We don't seek the power of God. We seek relationship with God. And through this relationship, the life of God flows through us just as the life of the vine flows into the branches which produce fruit. The river comes from the house. We are the house of God, collectively and individually. The river flows out because, number one, we've come to the door. Number two, we've come to the altar. And the altar is a place of death. It's where sin and self are crucified. It speaks of a lifestyle of prayer and sanctification and holiness before God. Because without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. Be thou holy, for the Lord thy God is holy. So this river is symbolic of the life and the flow of the Ruach HaKodesh. And we see Ezekiel, who represents the believer in the spirit, moving progressively from ankle deep to knee deep to waist deep to a place that's over his head. And the river comes out full flow from the very beginning, which tells us that when we receive the Ruach HaKodesh, it comes in fullness. It doesn't come as a dribble and then become a flood. It comes in its fullness immediately. Wow. But we're the ones that need to progress and mature in the anointing. And these waters were flowing with purpose. Its power was purpose. Luke 4:18, Yeshua said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach Besorah, good news, to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And then he closed the scroll of Isaiah and said, this prophecy has been fulfilled before your very eyes. You know, you don't have to be in jail to be a captive. You can be captive to sin, any kind of sin. You can allow it to dominate you, to put you in chains. They're not visible chains, but they're chains nonetheless, and you are a prisoner. But God anointed Yeshua of Nazareth with the Ruach HaKodesh and with power. And he went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the enemy. For God was with him, just as God will be with us. That's his promise. If you believe that he is, then you have to believe that his word is true. Every single bit of it. And this is his promise to his kids. The Ruach is here with a purpose. He came to empower us so that we can carry on Yeshua's ministry. He came to anoint us the same as he anointed Yeshua to destroy the works of the enemy. He came to set us on fire. Wow. Hebrews 1:7. Who makes his angels ministering spirits and his ministers flames of fire. Are we his ministers? Then we are flames of fire. He came to set us free. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. There is nothing to think about. And this river had miracle transforming power. It had saving and healing power because the river brought life, it brought healing, it brought restoration wherever it went. And that same river was in Yeshua. And that same river is in you by the power of the Ruach HaKodesh.
Amen.
And out of your belly shall flow rivers. Now, there may be some dead, dry places in your life because of sickness or finances or marital problems or children problems or whatever. What you need is the river of God to break loose in and through you so that all of those things can be washed away. That's what a river does. It washes things away. Paul said that we need to stir up the gift that's in us. Well, we do. I want Jackie to come up. And Jackie and I are going to lay hands on you. And the anointing is going to flow. And when it does, when we stir up the river, we're going to start stirring up the gifts that God has given to each and every one of you. There is healing in the river. There is deliverance in the river. There is breakthrough in the river. There are miracles in the river. It's the anointing, and the anointing is in each one of you. And when we lay hands on you, by the anointing, let your faith go. Jump in the river. Picture yourself ankle deep, knee deep, waist deep, and then floating in that river, because you don't have a care in the world, because if God be for you, who could be against you? Go after your joy. Choose joy. Go after your peace. Go after your healing. Go after your breakthrough. Go after your anointing. Now you got to decide whether you want to sit on the riverbank or jump in and let God carry you where he wants you to go. The Spirit of the Lord is here right now. It's upon me because he has appointed me and anointed me to preach good news, to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, recovery of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. So just lift up your hands and begin to stir. Stir up the anointing. Stir up the river. Let the river of God begin to flow inside of you. Stand up. Hallelujah. And if you've never been baptized with the Ruach HaKodesh, I want those people to come forward first. Because we want to lay hands on you. We want you to have the full measure of God's blessing. So if you've never been baptized in the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in a prayer language, those people come forward first. Hallelujah. That means everyone here has their prayer language. Nope, we got a couple people coming up. Hallelujah. Listen, don't be embarrassed. This is one of the things you all need to understand. Look, this is family here. Right? So what goes on in here is among family. And you can't say, well, sit in your seats and we'll let this thing work right where you are. No, you got to come forward and say, I'm not embarrassed to want this gift. I want it. I want it completely. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, sin la ba 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 she da 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 ba ba ba. Oh, oh, she la la. Let the power of the Holy Spirit come upon you. Let you speak in the gift of prayer language. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Cry out to the Lord. Tell, I want my prayer language. I want my prayer language. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Abba, Father, put your prayer language on them. Fill them to the full with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Let them feel your presence in a way that they've never felt it before. Hallelujah. Keep asking him to fill you. Fill me, fill me, fill me, fill me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, see, la la ba 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 ba, see, la 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 ba. Oh, see, la la ba ba ba, cry out to him in your prayer language. Hallelujah, ba ba ba, see, la 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 ba ba ba, see, la 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 ba ba ba. Oh, see, we need to pray in union with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We need to be of one accord. We need to pray for each other. We need to stand by one another. We need to uplift one another. We need to encourage one another. We need to be there for one another. We need to do for one another. When they're filled with joy, we need to be joyful. When they're sad, we need to weep with them. Hallelujah. That's what being brothers and sisters in the Lord is all about. It's about family, and we are family because we share the blood of the risen Messiah, and there is no greater bond than his blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, see, no, no, no. Now, I want everybody who wants an impartation, an increased filling of the Holy Spirit to come forward. Hallelujah. Oh, see, la la ba 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 she da da. Oh, see, la la ba 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 she da da. Ha sa ta ba 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 ba. Eh, see, ta ba 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 she da da. She la la ba 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 ba. She la la ba 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 ba. Rivers, rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. Hallelujah. Oh, see, na la ba 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 ba. Hallelujah. John the Immerser baptized with water, but he said, one will come after me. It will baptize with power and with fire. Fire, fire, fire. That's what we need. We need fire. We need fire to come upon us. Abba, Father, I call down your holy fire. I call down your fire from heaven. I ask you to touch each and every one of these people. I ask you to fill them to the full with your Holy Spirit. I ask you to empower them. I ask you to anoint them. I ask you to fill them. I ask you to bless them. I ask you to make them feel like they've never felt before in their life. Let the fire fall upon them, Lord. Let the fire fall upon them. Let them feel so much heat they won't know what to do. Hallelujah. Let the fire fall upon them. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, sin la la ba ba bo shi la la. Ah, la la ba ba bo shi. Hey, sin la la ba ba bo shi la. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Let your fire fall in this place. What better place for your fire to fall than in your sanctuary? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Let your fire fall. Let it fall. Let it fall. Let it fall. Let it fall on your children, Lord. Anoint them. Fill them. Deliver them. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, sin la la ba 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 shi, he la la ba ba shi ta ta, hey la la ba 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 shi na, ha la la ba 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 shi ta ta, hey la la ba ba ba, ha sin la la ba 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 ba, ha ba 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 shi ta ta. Oh Lord, we confess today that we love you, that we are your children. Hallelujah. He la la ba. We thank you for the infilling of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, for the fresh anointing that you've placed on us. We thank you, Lord, for the love and the power, the power, the power, the fire, the fire. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, fire. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh. Oh, Lord, whew. Your power is powerful. Whew. Miss Vicky, will you sing Holy Ground? Do you have your microphone? Where? Here. This is holy ground, because anywhere the Lord is holy. Hallelujah. So as you receive your anointing, hallelujah.
As I walk through the door, I sensed his presence.
Hallelujah.
And I knew this was a place where love abides.
Thank you, Lord.
For this is a temple Jehovah God resides in. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Everybody.
We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels all around. Let us praise Yeshua now. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Do you feel his presence? See, just bask in it. You don't have to rush. Just let him speak to you. This is the perfect time to ask him that question that's been on your heart. This is the perfect time to cry out to him for whatever it is you would like him to do for you. Remember what his word says. Anything you ask, believing that I will do for you. It's his desire to do for you. It's his desire to do for you, for each and every individual one of you, because you are all unique. You are all his creation. He numbered every hair on your head. He knitted you in your mother's womb. He has loved you with an everlasting love from before the foundations of the earth. You are precious in his sight. You are worthy. It doesn't matter what the world says. The only thing that matters is what he says. And he says, I love you. He says, you come to me and I will take care of you. I don't care what's coming against you. I don't care what the world says. Look to me. Don't look to them. Look to me, because I am the source. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, sin la la ba 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 ba. Oh, sin la la ba ba ba. God is moving in a powerful way in here today. Thank you, Lord.
In his presence, there is joy beyond measure.
Amen.
And at his feet, sweet peace of mind can still be found. If you have a need, I know he has the answer. Just reach out and claim it, child. We are standing on holy ground.
Amen.
We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels all around. Let us praise Yeshua now. We are standing in his presence, standing in his sweet and holy presence. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Oh, hallelujah. Yivarecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. Ya'er Adonai panavalecha v'ihunecha. Yisa Adonai panavalecha v'yosemlecha shalom. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. B'shem Yeshua, in the name of Yeshua, the Sar Shalom, the Prince of Peace. Amen. Hallelujah. May you be blessed not only this Shabbat, but this whole entire coming week. May he give you the desires of your heart. May he speak to you even as you sleep in accordance with his word. In Yeshua's name, amen and amen. Greet each other with a hug. Can you feel a difference in the air here today? Yeah, there is a significant difference. There really is. And it's absolutely awesome. It's amazing what God will do if we're in sync with him. Shavuot starts tonight at sundown. And I spoke last week about how important Shavuot is, that it's the anniversary of the giving the law on Mount Sinai, and it's the anniversary of giving the Spirit in the upper room. Acts Chapter 1, verse 8 says, you shall receive power after the Ruach HaKodesh has come, and you will be witnesses unto me in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. So let's break that down. We're going to receive power, not only power, but we're going to receive authority. And what is the purpose of that power and that authority? To be witnesses. Do you think he would give us that power and that authority so that we can say, thank you, Lord, and sit on our, you know what? The purpose for giving us power and authority is for us to go out and bring people in to share the Basura, the good news. That's the purpose of giving us power and authority. Luke 24:49 says, now I am sending forth upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been equipped with power from above. This is not earthly power. This is supernatural power that comes from the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And the number one need in the body today is the power of the Ruach HaKodesh, because without it, we're powerless. The number one prerequisite for having that power is to hunger after it. We have to desire it. We have to want it. Matthew 5:6 says, blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Not may be filled, shall be filled. It's automatic. The most dangerous thing that can happen to a believer is to lose their hunger and their passion and their desire for the presence and the power of God.
Amen.
Amen is right. Let me tell you, you all need to start responding. See, this is not a soliloquy. This is group participation. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Can I hear a louder amen?
Amen?
Amen. We need to get excited about the Word of God. Let me tell you about the Word of God. I said to Jackie yesterday, I said, Jackie, I want to go to this service, healing service tonight. And she said, why do you want to go? I said, well, I know of the guy that's going to be there, Bob Weiner, and he's got a really great reputation, and we both need a touch, so let's go. So we got there. It was called for 7:30 in Cooper City. It was part of the South Florida Pastors Network who sponsored it. And we're looking around, and it's a miracle and healing service, and there's nobody there. And I looked at Jackie, and she looked at me, and I said, I don't understand this. I know there are hurting people all over South Florida. Why aren't there lines around the building? Why is it? And ultimately, it only got half full, if that. And it wasn't that big a facility. Listen, you have to hunger after your healing. You have to hunger after your deliverance. You can't sit there and wait for God to drop it in your lap. You need to be proactive.
Amen.
So he did a message that I recorded that was, I thought, he was right on the money. And he goes on college campuses all over the country and plants churches. He went into the University of Florida, which is a hotbed of communism, and they now have prayer meetings right on campus that have thousands of people attending them every Sunday night. He's planted thousands of churches all over the world, and he does it based on a simple principle. Go get them, disciple them, tell them the whole truth and nothing but the truth. Do not sugarcoat it. Do not give them these phony, joy-filled messages that life is going to be a bed of roses. Disciple them. Tell them the truth. Turn them loose and let them multiply. And toward the end of the service, he said, I want to pray for everyone who needs a healing. Well, I guess about 20 people went up, and he keeps looking at me. And we're right there by the stage, and he keeps looking at me. He doesn't say anything, but he keeps looking at me. And we're making, I mean, we're 4 feet apart, and he keeps making eye contact with me. And he says, okay, now anybody who feels that they were healed, I want you to come up here. Come up here. So several people come up, and they give a brief testimony, and, you know. And I said to Jackie, I said, I can move my right arm. I said, I don't know what happened, but for the last 3 years, I haven't been able to do this. She says, well, get up there. So I went up there, and he said, I was wondering how long it was going to take you to get up here, because I know the Lord healed you. He told me. Well, they told me I needed a shoulder replacement, but I could not do that. I haven't been able to sleep on this shoulder in 3 years. I slept on that shoulder last night. So, you know, I'm not telling you this because I'm special. I'm telling you this because God wants to heal you. He wants to deliver you from whatever is coming against you. But you know what? You got to trust that he can do it. Because if you don't trust that he can do it, guess what? That will be your reality. But if you believe with every fiber of your being that he is who he says he is, that he will do exactly what he says he will do, then by golly, you will be healed. You will be set free. That's how simple it is. So the most dangerous thing that can happen to a believer is to lose their hunger and their passion and their desire for the presence and the power of God. Let me hear an amen. Amen. That's better. Wow. You know, when you respond like that, it empowers me. It does. It sets me more on fire. I'm already on fire. I really feel it. I feel the presence of the Lord. I felt it all morning in here. There is a different atmosphere in here. There is an atmosphere of joy in here. Hallelujah. Come with me to Ezekiel chapter 47. Ezekiel 47 shows us a picture of the mighty river of God. And that river represents the Holy Spirit, the Ruach HaKodesh, the anointing, if you will. Then he brought me back to the entrance of the house, and I saw water flowing eastward from under the threshold of the house, for the house faced eastward. And the water flowed down from under the right side of the house, south of the altar. Next, he led me out through the north gate and took me around the outside to the outer gate by way of the east gate, where I saw water trickling from the south side. And with a line in his hand, the man went out toward the east and measured 1,000 cubits. That's approximately a third of a mile. And he had me wade across the stream. And the water came up to my ankles. And he measured 1,000 and had me wade the water. This time the water reached my knees. And he measured 1,000. He made me wade up to my waist. And he measured 1,000, and it was a river, and I couldn't cross it on foot because the water was so deep one would have to swim across. It was a river that could not be waded through. And he asked me, human being, have you seen this? Then guiding me, he got me back to the riverbank. And after being returned, I saw on the bank of the river a great number of trees on the one side and on the other side. And he said to me, this water flows toward the eastern region and continues down to the Arava. When it enters the sea of stagnant water, the Dead Sea, its waters will become fresh. Well, I don't know if you've ever been to the Dead Sea, but the salt content in the Dead Sea is so high that you cannot swim in that water. It is impossible. All you can do is lay back and float. And that water is so buoyant that you can read a newspaper while you're floating in the Dead Sea. And for that water to be turned fresh, only the God of Israel could accomplish that miracle. Hallelujah. And when this happens, swarms of all kinds of living creatures will be able to live in it wherever the streams flow, so that there will be a vast number of fish. For this water is flowing there so that wherever the river goes, everything will be restored and will be able to live. Can you picture this? God is a God of restoration. He can take a wilderness. He can take something that's dead and bring it back to life. Amen? Hallelujah. Psalm 46:4 says, there is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God. I want to tell you, we've come to the door of that river. We're right there. And this doesn't mean just come to Yeshua as a point of access, but it means come to Yeshua and fellowship with him and commune with him and have a relationship with him and talk to him, panim el panim, face to face. He is the living God. He is the Word that became flesh and dwelt among us. He is the one that allows us to tabernacle with He and the Father for all eternity, because He paid the price that was due each and every one of us. Amen would be appropriate, maybe even hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. John 7:37. If any man thirst, let him come to me and drink, and he that believes upon me, as the scriptures have said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. Thus he spoke of the Spirit. For the Ruach HaKodesh had not yet been given because Yeshua was not yet glorified. But what he was prophesying to them was, stick around. You ain't seen nothing yet. I'm going to fill you with power from above. Dunamis power, dynamite power, power like you've never seen before, power that will enable you to raise the dead, to heal the sick, to cast out demons, to do all kinds of things in my name and under my authority. Yeshua said, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall bring forth much fruit. How do you know believers? By their fruit. No fruit? You got to ask yourself a really important question. What does Yaakov say? What does he say? No fruit, no salvation. Wow. We all have to bear fruit. I like pineapples. Of course, we have a lemon tree and it's bearing fruit, and I like those lemons too. So maybe we combine the two, it'll be a lemon pineapple. But we do, really, all seriousness aside, we have to bear fruit for the kingdom. He also said, if you abide not in me, you will be cast forth like a dead branch and cast into the fire. What does it mean to abide in him? Does that mean that you say a prayer and recognize him as Lord and Master of your life and then go about your business? No, abiding in him is making him Lord and Master. That means you go to him with every issue, little or big, and consult with him. Because you want to be in the will of God, not out of the will of God. And how do you know what the will of God is? You ask. You have his word to tell you the basics. But if you're undecided, if you still don't understand, you just go before the throne and you say, "Explain it to me." And guess what? That's exactly what he will do. His word says, if you lack wisdom, to ask, and he will pour it out, how? Liberally. Amen? Hallelujah. Wow. So the secret to abundant life, overflowing life, and anointed life is a life lived in fellowship with Messiah Yeshua. You can't have the abundant life without the relationship. And that relationship means that he comes first. Not your spouse, not your kids, not your job, not anything. That he has to come first. And that you have to choose to put him first. Amen? Our goal is not to have the power of God, but to have the presence of God. Hallelujah. We don't seek the power of God. We seek relationship with God. And through this relationship, the life of God flows through us just as the life of the vine flows into the branches which produce fruit. The river comes from the house. We are the house of God, collectively and individually. The river flows out because, number one, we've come to the door. Number two, we've come to the altar. And the altar is a place of death. It's where sin and self are crucified. It speaks of a lifestyle of prayer and sanctification and holiness before God. Because without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. Be thou holy, for the Lord thy God is holy. So this river is symbolic of the life and the flow of the Ruach HaKodesh. And we see Ezekiel, who represents the believer in the spirit, moving progressively from ankle deep to knee deep to waist deep to a place that's over his head. And the river comes out full flow from the very beginning, which tells us that when we receive the Ruach HaKodesh, it comes in fullness. It doesn't come as a dribble and then become a flood. It comes in its fullness immediately. Wow. But we're the ones that need to progress and mature in the anointing. And these waters were flowing with purpose. Its power was purpose. Luke 4:18, Yeshua said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach Besora, good news to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." And then he closed the scroll of Isaiah and said, "This prophecy has been fulfilled before your very eyes." You know, you don't have to be in jail to be a captive. You can be captive to sin, any kind of sin. You can allow it to dominate you, to put you in chains. They're not visible chains, but they're chains nonetheless, and you are a prisoner. But God anointed Yeshua of Nazareth with the Ruach HaKodesh and with power. And he went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the enemy, for God was with him, just as God will be with us. That's his promise. If you believe that he is, then you have to believe that his word is true. Every single bit of it. And this is his promise to his kids. The Ruach is here with a purpose. He came to empower us so that we can carry on Yeshua's ministry. He came to anoint us the same as he anointed Yeshua to destroy the works of the enemy. He came to set us on fire. Wow. Hebrews 1:7, who makes his angels ministering spirits and his ministers flames of fire. Are we his ministers? Then we are flames of fire. He came to set us free. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. There is nothing to think about. Wow. And this river had miracle transforming power. It had saving and healing power. Because the river brought life. It brought healing. It brought restoration wherever it went. And that same river was in Yeshua. And that same river is in you by the power of the Ruach HaKodesh. Amen. And out of your belly shall flow rivers. Now there may be some dead, dry places in your life because of sickness or finances or marital problems or children problems or whatever. What you need is the river of God to break loose in and through you so that all of those things can be washed away. That's what a river does. It washes things away. Wow. Paul said that we need to stir up the gift that's in us. Well, we do. I want Jackie to come up, and Jackie and I are going to lay hands on you, and the anointing is going to flow, and when it does, when we stir up the river, we're going to start stirring up the gifts that God has given to each and every one of you. There is healing in the river. There is deliverance in the river. There is breakthrough in the river. There are miracles in the river. It's the anointing, and the anointing is in each one of you. And when we lay hands on you, by the anointing, let your faith go. Jump in the river. Picture yourself ankle deep, knee deep, waist deep, and then floating in that river. Because you don't have a care in the world. Because if God be for you, who could be against you? Go after your joy. Choose joy. Go after your peace. Go after your healing. Go after your breakthrough. Go after your anointing. Now you got to decide whether you want to sit on the riverbank or jump in and let God carry you where he wants you to go. The Spirit of the Lord is here right now. It's upon me because he has appointed me and anointed me to preach good news, to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, recovery of sight to the blind, and to set at liberty them that are bruised, and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. So just lift up your hands and begin to stir. Stir up the anointing. Stir up the river. Let the river of God begin to flow inside of you. Stand up. Hallelujah. And if you've never been baptized with the Ruach HaKodesh, I want those people to come forward first. because we want to lay hands on you. We want you to have the full measure of God's blessing. So if you've never been baptized in the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in a prayer language, those people come forward first. Hallelujah. That means everyone here has their prayer language. Nope, we got a couple people coming up. Hallelujah. Listen, don't be embarrassed. This is one of the things you all need to understand. Look, this is family here, right? So what goes on in here is among family. And you can't say, well, sit in your seats and we'll let this thing work right where you are. No, you got to come forward and say, I'm not embarrassed to want this gift. I want it. I want it completely. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, sin la la ba ba bo she da 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 ba ba bo. Oh, oh, she la la. Let the power of the Holy Spirit come upon you. Let you speak in the gift of prayer language. Hallelujah. 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 Cry out to the Lord. Tell, I want my prayer language. I want my prayer language. Hallelujah. 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 Abba, Father, put your prayer language on them. Fill them to the full with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Let them feel your presence in a way that they've never felt it before. Hallelujah. Keep asking him to fill you. Fill me, fill me, fill me, fill me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, see, la la ba 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 ba, she la la ba ba. Oh, see, la la ba ba ba, cry out to him in your prayer language. Hallelujah, ba ba ba, see, la 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 ba ba ba, she la 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 ba ba ba. Oh, see, la la ba ba ba. We need to pray in union with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We need to be of one accord. We need to pray for each other. We need to stand by one another. We need to uplift one another. We need to encourage one another. We need to be there for one another. We need to do for one another. When they're filled with joy, we need to be joyful. When they're sad, we need to weep with them. Hallelujah. That's what being brothers and sisters in the Lord is all about. It's about family, and we are family because we share the blood of the risen Messiah, and there is no greater bond than his blood. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, see, no, no, no. Now, I want everybody who wants an impartation, an increased filling of the Holy Spirit to come forward. Hallelujah. Oh, see, la la ba 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 ba. Oh, see, la la ba 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 ba. Ha, sa, ta, pa, 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 pa. Eh, si, ta, pa, 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 ba, shi, ta, ta. Si, la, la, ba, 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 ba. Si, la, la, ba, 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 ba. Eh, si, la, 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 ba, ba. Rivers, rivers of living water. Ha, la, ba, 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 shi, na, na, la. Rivers of living water. Hallelujah. Oh, si, la, la, ba, 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 ba. Hallelujah. John the Immerser baptized with water, but he said, one will come after me who will baptize with power and with fire. Fire, fire, fire. That's what we need. We need fire. We need fire to come upon us. Abba, Father, I call down your holy fire. I call down your fire from heaven. I ask you to touch each and every one of these people. I ask you to fill them to the full with your Holy Spirit. I ask you to empower them. I ask you to anoint them. I ask you to fill them. I ask you to bless them. I ask you to make them feel like they've never felt before in their life. Let the fire fall upon them, Lord. Let the fire fall upon them. Let them feel so much heat they won't know what to do. Hallelujah. Let the fire fall upon them. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, seen la la ba ba bo she la la. Ah, la la ba ba bo she. Hey, seen la la ba ba bo she na. Oh. Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Let your fire fall in this place. What better place for your fire to fall than in your sanctuary? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Let your fire fall. Let it fall. Let it fall. Let it fall. Let it fall on your children, Lord. Anoint them. Fill them. Deliver them. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, sin la la ba 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 shi. He la la ba ba shi. Hey, la la ba 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 shi. Ah, la la ba 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 shi. Hey, la la ba ba ba. Ah, sin la la ba 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 ba. Ah, ba 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 shi. Oh, Lord, we confess today that we love you, that we are your children. Hallelujah. We thank you for the infilling of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, Lord, for the fresh anointing that you've placed on us. We thank you, Lord, for the love and the power, the power, the power, the fire, the fire. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, fire. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, oh Lord. Whew. Your power is powerful. Whew. Miss Vicky, will you sing Holy Ground? Do you have your microphone? Where? Here. This is holy ground, because anywhere the Lord is holy. Hallelujah. So as you receive your anointing, hallelujah.
As I walk through the door, I sensed his presence.
Hallelujah.
And I knew this was a place where love abides.
Thank you, Lord.
For this is a temple Jehovah God resides in. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Everybody.
We are standing on holy ground, and I know that there are angels all around. Let us praise Yeshua now. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Hallelujah. Woo. Do you feel his presence? See, just bask in it. You don't have to rush. Just let him speak to you. This is the perfect time to ask him that question that's been on your heart. This is the perfect time to cry out to him for whatever it is you would like him to do for you. Remember what his word says. Anything you ask, believing that I will do for you. It's his desire to do for you. It's his desire to do for you, for each and every individual one of you, because you are all unique. You are all his creation. He numbered every hair on your head. He knitted you in your mother's womb. He has loved you with an everlasting love from before the foundations of the earth. You are precious in his sight. You are worthy. It doesn't matter what the world says. The only thing that matters is what he says. And he says, I love you. He says, you come to me and I will take care of you. I don't care what's coming against you. I don't care what the world says. Look to me. Don't look to them. Look to me, because I am the source. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, sin la la ba 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 ba. Oh, sin la la ba 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 ba. God is moving in a powerful way in here. Thank you, Lord.
In his presence, there is joy beyond measure.
Amen.
And at his feet, sweet peace of mind can still be found. If you have a need, I know he has the answer. Just reach out and claim it, child. We are standing on holy ground.
Amen.
We are standing on holy ground. And I know that there are angels all around. Let us praise Yeshua now. We are standing in his presence, standing in his sweet and holy presence. We are standing in his presence on holy ground.
Oh, hallelujah. Yivarecha Adonai v'yishmerecha. Ya'er Adonai panav alecha v'yihunecha. Yisa Adonai panav alecha v'yosem lecha. Shalom. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. B'shem Yeshua, in the name of Yeshua, the Sar Shalom, the Prince of Peace. Amen. Hallelujah. May you be blessed not only this Shabbat, but this whole entire coming week. May he give you the desires of your heart. May he speak to you even as you sleep in accordance with his word. Yeshua's name, amen and amen. Greet each other with a hug.